Mostly everyone who lands in Ontario, Canada, they stay in Brampton for few days, few weeks, few months in the beginning mostly. And after staying for 2-3 days in Toronto, we also stayed in Brampton, as you know, for 2 months in the basement. I think we have enough experience to share with you, and we are going to tell you why we moved out of Brampton within 2 months. So watch this video till the end.
Just a disclaimer, this is our personal experience.
Yep. So as you all know that we stayed in Brampton for 2 months in the basement. So it was little depressing because it was winter season, and we found out a lot of nice apartments in Mississauga, especially around the lakeshore. So we moved here. But initially, when you don't have a job, you don't have a lot of savings from your home country, then you will have to find a home in Brampton, a basement maybe, because it's little cheaper.
And that's maybe one of the reasons that why a lot of people stay in Brampton initially, because you still get accommodation in Brampton without a job offer. There are some good landlords who still give the basements to people who are still new to the country. So that's a good thing.
And houses in Brampton are the most beautiful.
Beautiful.
You will not find beautiful and cheap houses other than Brampton. If you go to Mississauga, Scarborough, Pickering, other areas, especially in Toronto, the houses are very costly. Especially in Oakville area, the houses are very old and very costly. In Brampton, you will find a very beautiful houses, very spacious, huge houses. So the first reason was that it was a basement, and it was a little depressing from us because we are from Delhi. We are used to see a lot of people, used to hear a lot of noises, honking. But a basement in winter is very depressing.
So it was a walk-in basement, so that may be a reason.
So as we talked about in our accommodation video, if you go for a walkout basement, you will have more light coming in the basement, so it might not be that depressing.
Another reason for us to move out of Brampton was the distance from downtown Toronto. I got job in downtown Toronto, and it used to take me 2 hours commute one side. I used to take a bus, then go train. So it was a lot of commute for me, especially when it was winter time. So we thought of moving out of Brampton for this very reason.
Because it is very difficult to take buses, stand in the bus stand if it's snowing a lot. So it's better to take an apartment or a basement or a house near the GO station, so that you can directly take a GO train to your office or downtown Toronto.
The GO train from Brampton to downtown Toronto has a frequency of 1 hour, as compared to other lines which are on a frequency of every 15 minutes. So that's a huge thing to consider. Also, since the frequency is every 1 hour, the trains are usually very crowded and you will hardly find a seat in the train.
So by the time she was coming back in the evening, she was very, very exhausted. And sometimes I did not have dinner because she was tired. She was not cooking. So he had to move to near to GO station.
So he lost a lot of weight because of that. So
and when we moved here, I gained a lot of weight.
Yeah.
Anyway, moving to next reason. So when we were in Brampton, we attended one festival, which is Mississauga Waterfront Festival, and we came to lakeshore of Mississauga. We really loved that area because the GO station was very near. There were a lot of apartments, so we decided to move there. And if you are on the lakeshore, you will get to see a lot of natural beauty, which is all around you in Canada. You should have a very good camera to shoot all those FPV movements. And let me also show you some great shots that we took from this cab. It also has a camera, so you always need a HD camera along with you to shoot all these amazing, beautiful scenes. So make sure that you have similar kind of cameras. Link is in the description.
Another reason, since we are here 12,000 kilometers away from India, so this is a great opportunity for us to experience and live with other communities. We found that we can experience that better in other cities than Brampton. So we thought of moving out of Brampton for the very reason.
Yeah, it is beautiful, but it felt like that we are in India only, Delhi, Punjab. So we wanted to be with other communities, and it is very easy to gel along with other communities from other countries in cities outside Brampton. So we will be there in Brampton to see our Desi people and enjoy with them.
But the food
and everything, that is one of the reason why we moved out. And here we are chilling along with other communities from other countries, learning their culture and showing them how we enjoy our festivals and sharing some positive from our culture. Another reason which will save a lot of money for you as well, that is the car insurance. So in Brampton, the car insurance is the most expensive. When I moved out of Brampton, my car insurance decreased by $100 per month. So you can imagine that is a huge difference. So even if your rent is high outside Brampton, you will be able to compensate on the car insurance or maybe on the travel time, travel expenses as well. Mm-hmm. I think your expenses were around 400-500 when you were traveling from Brampton.
Yeah.
And that also reduced to 200-300. So even if the rents in the apartment are high in Mississauga, you will be able to compensate with the car insurance and the travel expenses. And I don't want to tell you why the car insurance is so expensive in Brampton. If you know the reason, just put that in the comment section, why you think the car insurance is so high in Brampton. I don't want to call it out.
Another reason, if you don't really want to travel to downtown Toronto, there are a lot of big companies that are moving out of downtown and moving to suburbs like Mississauga and other cities. So that way, if you live in Mississauga or maybe Oakville, you will save on a lot of time when it comes to traveling to office.
Now we should also tell you the things that we really miss about Brampton. First and most important thing is food.
Food.
We really miss the Brampton food because that's the most closest to Indian food, Indian taste. Although we couldn't find chole bhature, the Indian style, Delhi style chole bhature. If you find it, please let us know.
But we did find samosa.
Samosa, non-veg, everything, all the Indian dishes which are very close to Indian taste. So in Brampton, everything is very, very cheap. If you find a mechanic, very cheap. If you go to a salon, very cheap. If there are some shops, some convenience shop, most of the things will be very, very cheap compared to Mississauga or Oakville or Scarborough, and you will find everything at one place. You don't have to travel a lot. If you move to Scarborough, just to go to another Indian restaurant, you will have to drive for half an hour. So Scarborough people don't feel bad about it, but that's the fact. But for Brampton, you can just drive for 5 minutes or 10 minutes, you will find some Indian restaurant or some Indian taste, Indian food joint that will serve you Indian snacks or Indian food.
Another good thing about Brampton is that you don't really need an appointment to get any service, like going to salon, going for spa or things like those. So whenever we don't have any pre-booked appointment, we always look towards Brampton.
So it doesn't mean that all the centers in Brampton don't ask for appointment, but there are few centers where you can go walk in and they will provide you services. Unlike Mississauga, you will have to have an appointment 2-3 days before if you want a haircut. So I had to wait for 1 month because I was not getting any appointment, I was not getting time. But I went to Brampton, got my haircut, it was a walk-in, simple. So if you get homesick very quickly, Brampton is the place you should stay forever, because you will not feel that you are out of India or out of Delhi, out of Punjab. You will always find desi people around you, so you will never feel homesick. You will be able to play cricket. It is very difficult to find a cricket team in Mississauga or any other area, but in Brampton I was playing cricket every day. In Mississauga, it is very difficult to find people and ground. If you are a cricket lover, you will find easily. There will be some team who will be playing in a ground near you.
Another good thing about Brampton, you will see a lot of big parks in every neighborhood. Unlike Mississauga, even though we have waterfront here, we don't have really big parks. So that's one disadvantage.
Don't say that. But in Brampton, there are more parks.
Yeah, and especially if you have kids, so they will enjoy more in Brampton parks. Okay, so this was all about why and why not Brampton. So if there are people who are watching us from Canada, from Ontario specifically, do let us know which city do you prefer. Do you like living in Brampton or do you like living outside Brampton? Comment down below.
And what are your views about Brampton? We want to know your thought as well. Make sure to like the video or dislike the video if you don't like it. Put down the comments as well so that we can make better videos going forward. Do not forget to subscribe even if you dislike the video so that you can see the improvement in next video. So till next time,
take care.